Time for 5 good minutes with ESPN NBA analyst Brian Windhorst here on the ESPN Cleveland social media platforms. I'm Matt Fontana. And Windy, a tough loss for the Cavs against the 76ers back on Wednesday night. But I wanted to start 5 good minutes here just with your thoughts overall on how the Cavs have played against some of the better teams. Not even specifically in the East, but, you know, they've had tough matchups against the Nuggets. They played, it seems like, Brian, some really good teams, really tough, but there are some of those games they just can't find a way to get the win.
Yeah, they're good, but they're not good enough to compete at the highest level. Go back in the history of the last 20 years and find the trades where you can trade for an all-NBA player without giving up on all-NBA player. We're talking about a single-digit number. And so to be able to do that is terrific. And Evan Mobley has definitely improved. He's got more room to improve. He's definitely improved, though. And they've definitely taken a step forward. They are definitely one of the top teams in the league now. They're one of the top 10 teams in the league, but they're not one of the top five. And when they play one of the top five, you see that. Now, they do have, they've had moments, you know, they had some good moments against the Celtics, for example. But you can see these last two games against the Sixers. The Sixers are a better team. They proved that, you know, twice now in the last month. You know, the Bucks are a better team. The Celtics, it would be interesting to see them in a series. And, you know, I don't know if that's going to happen, but the Celtics are a better team. So, you know, the key for the Cavs is to hit their level, which to me is to get home court and to win that first round series. I think that's a legitimate thing. And I think that's going to be hard. It's going to be hard to lock down the fourth seed. It's going to be hard to win 4 out of 7. But if they do that, it's going to be a terrific step forward season. And you can either focus on what they're not, or you can focus on what they are, and I would focus on what they are. And when we get to the summer, we'll really drill down on what they can do to get where they're not.
Brian, you mentioned the 4 seed there. How important is it for this team, who's clearly much better at home, to stay in that spot? Obviously, the Knicks were pushing. It seems like the Cavs, you know, Brian, I don't want to put the cart before the horse, but with the Cavs' schedule on the way out, with where they sit, feels pretty good they're going to get that 4 seed and a home court advantage here in the first round. How important is that to this young team?
Yeah, they have a great opportunity to secure. So next week they go to Brooklyn for the baseball series. They play 2 games in Brooklyn. They can bury the Nets if they handle their business in that series. They have, I think, 1 more game with the Knicks. I think it's at home, maybe in about 10 or 12 days or something. Another great opportunity. You know, they got to get Jared Allen right. They got to make sure his eye is right. Their bench is shaky. Danny Green is starting to play a little bit more, so that could be important. But, you know, they can have their full control of their destiny. If they take and handle their business, and before the Sixers game, they'd won 5 out of 6. And, you know, splitting in Miami is appropriate. You know, you'd like to take 2, but they split. And if they were playing a playoff series against Miami and they split, they would have done well. So take care of Brooklyn next week. If you do that, you'll be in really good shape, because I think the Knicks are still going to take some losses. Their schedule is a little bit harder than the Cavs. So, I think the most important thing is when they secure the 4 seed, that they also are finding an identity that they want to play towards the playoffs, because right now, JB Bickerstaff doesn't have a 7 or 8 man rotation. He's searching. And that's probably just as important as home court, is knowing how you're going to play going into the postseason. And that's where they have some work to do in this last 3 weeks.
Final thing, Brian, we're going right there, that rotation. So we've seen Danny Green a little bit, still coming off the ACL. You know, Rubio not playing on the back-to-backs, management there. Obviously, and then guys, you know, are going to start. Donovan's dealing with his hand. I know Darius got knee in the thigh, Jared Allen with the eye, but just where do you see that Cavs rotation? I think, really, Bri, a big question for me is Danny Green. I know he's still coming off that ACL. He's a little bit of an older guy. Should I have expectations that he'll find minutes in a playoff series? And what do you believe about the rest of that Cavs bench?
Yeah, it's a pretty important thing. You know, in this last week, we've seen Jetty Osmond. You know, when Jetty Osmond, like in that game in Charlotte, when Jetty makes shots, it's amazing how much different they look. When they can get production offensively from the 3 spot, it changes everything. And so that's why they're probably going to try anything that they can to get Danny Green going. And I think you'll see them try to get him going a little bit more, because like Isaac Okoro is just not going to bring it. I know he's gotten better, but he's just not good enough. The opposition is not going to guard him. And to be honest with you, you don't want the ball in his hands in fourth quarters of tight playoff games. I'm not saying he can't hit a shot or two that could help, but you don't want to rely on that. You feel a lot better with the ball ends up in Danny Green's hands in that spot. And look, if Danny Green may get that shot and he may miss it, but you can only set the table and hope that it goes your way. That's a lot of what playoff basketball is giving yourself the best chance to do it. And I just think that it's going to be hard to, I think Okoro will absolutely be the starter. No question. He'll get a lot of minutes. I don't think when these, 50-50 games come down to it at the end, I don't think he can be out there. If you put him out there, you're going to pay the price. And so they maybe could survive having Okoro out there if they had a four-man who could stretch the floor. And, we've seen in recent games here, they've had Lamar Stevens out there with Mobley, leaving Mobley out there as the center. I think that's promising, but it can't be Lamar Stevens as the four. It's got to be a four who can shoot. So the fact that Dean Wade has completely gone away since coming back from this injury and has been a non-factor and JB isn't playing him, that's worrisome, because more than just Dean Wade producing, you want to be able to have that lineup to go to that you can say, okay, we need a lineup to stretch the floor. Let's go to our small lineup. And then Dean Wade could go stand in the corner, or they could run actions for him and the opposing team would have to guard it. They don't have that right now. When he goes to a small lineup, he's going to Lamar Stevens. And I know why he does it, because Lamar plays hard, even when he's not doing anything offensively, he makes plays defensively. But it would really, really be good if the Cavs get to a place where they could put a Dean Wade lineup out there, so that at least they know that they could put a stretch big man on the court and believe in it. Especially, of course, Fontana, with the fact that they had that lineup in their repertoire and they said goodbye to it when they said goodbye to Kevin Love. Because no matter what you think about Kevin Love, no matter what he was shooting, if you put him out there and he stood in the corner, you had to guard him. And they don't have that now. And you'd also like to be able to put your two big lineup out there with the three man that the other team would care about stretching the floor. And that is not going to be Okoro. That's going to be Danny Green. So between now and April 15th, what you really want to see is obviously health. You want to see locking down the four seed. And you'd really, really like to get to the point where you could trust putting Danny Green and Dean Wade out there in lineups where they're not right now. And so that's a lot to expect in 3 weeks, but all of that is doable. Dean Wade didn't forget how to play. He's just got to get back into a rotation. And frankly, JB probably has to play him. Even if he doesn't like it, I know the other night in Charlotte, he had a very ineffective stretch. I think you got to play him, because I think it's so important to do that. I know Donovan's going to show up. I know Garland's going to show up. I know Mobley's going to show up. I know Allen's going to show up, but they're going to need to have lineup flexibility if they're going to do anything when we get into the postseason.
Appreciate it, Bri. Great stuff. Break up a little bit of the NFL free agency that's going out with everybody, with a little bit of basketball talk. And I know, Bri, in the NBA, free agency is also a giant time of things, but I think the NBA is just so different because a lot of times those moves are big, huge, massive players that are leaving for another team. It's just a little bit different. I mean, I guess there are big players, Aaron Rodgers moving teams, but it's just a little different in the NBA when it comes to free agency.
Well, we don't have a franchise tag in the NBA. They've tried to get it a couple of different times, and we're on the verge of getting a new collective bargaining agreement in the NBA. I think we'll have it by either the end of this month or early next. And there's not going to be a franchise tag in that CBA either. So there won't be that coming anytime soon. So when you can't protect your number one player, it makes free agency a lot more interesting.
Well, and fully guaranteed deals are already a thing in the NBA, so we don't have to worry about that either compared to the NFL. Great stuff here on 5 Good Minutes with ESPN NBA analyst Brian Windhorst here on the ESPN Cleveland social media platforms.